We are the AutoTune. Where's the AutoTune? Today we are gonna AutoTune this vocal.
I feel so close to you right now, it's like a force field.
Into this vocal.
I feel so close to you right now, it's like a force field.
This is Olen here, let's go! To load AutoTune in FL Studio Mobile, just select the channel that your audio is in, press the arrow, press plus, and select Auto Pitch. This is the FX AutoTune inside FL Studio Mobile. So first put in the scale and the key. But wait, what is the scale and key of my acapella? Well, to find the key for acapella, if you're using a famous song, it's very easy. Just go to Google search, type in your song name plus the word key, and you would see the key for your song. For this song, it's actually a major scale and a C. So it's actually a C major key. This is a simplified explanation for the key of your song. It is actually a scale where there's many notes that play in harmony with each other. But I think that's for a separate video. If you want me to make a tutorial on that, just comment down below, scale tutorial please. If I get 10 comments, I'll do a video on that, alright? Continuing, we have the speed, which is how fast the AutoTune is applied to your song. So the faster it is, you sound very artificial, robotic. But if too slow, there's less AutoTune, but it sounds more natural. So I'm going to show you 100 first, then I'm going to go to 25, which I think is the perfect match.
I feel so close to you right now, it's like a force field.
So very robotic.
I wear my heart upon my sleeves like a big deal. I feel so close to you right now.
So 25 is just nice. Next, the pitch allows you to tune your vocal up one semitone or down one semitone, and then the fine tune just allows you to make finer adjustments. So I really wouldn't use this unless I really want to tune my audio.
I feel so close to you right now, it's like a force field. I wear my heart upon my sleeves like a big deal.
So now if I go down.
Your love pours down on me, surround me like a waterfall.
So maybe if like you want to do like future bass, low sound vocals, then maybe you can use this one. And for F mode, just turn it on. From what I know, it allows FL Studio Mobile to adjust your vocal to be more similar to the human resonance. Basically, just turn it on. So
I feel so close to you right now, it's like a force field.
Here also you can F shift your vocal so that it sounds like the low robotic that I said that if you're doing future bass you can use as well. For example, if I do 0.9.
I feel so close to you right now, it's like a force field.
Hey wait, how about the advanced section? Well, I'm going to cover that, no worries. So what is this BYP thing? So it actually allows you to bypass certain notes. So for example, right, let's say in this song I'm using melodies that uses the key C, D, F and G, but not using E, and I don't want my audio to ever touch E. So from there I can just go to advanced and bypass the E. From there, when I auto-tune, the vocal will not touch E at all.
I feel so close to you right now, it's like a force field.
For pitch reference, basically, you don't have to touch it unless you're using a stereo vocal, which you want to adjust the auto-tune on the left side only, while on the right side you can listen to the original vocal. Basically, just don't touch it. For the bass frequency, is for you to adjust your bass A note. Other frequency follows the bass A note, and if you want to adjust the whole thing up, you can adjust it using this knob here. But normally, under normal circumstances, we won't touch it. And for stability, if you felt that the audio is jumping up and down and moving in between two notes very fast, like that, you can use stability to make your auto-tune more stable. So I've left it at 100 to make my vocal very stable. And mix is quite an interesting thing. You can actually auto-tune like 50% of your audio only, leaving the other half not auto-tuned, so it creates like this chorus effect. So I'm going to try 50% right now and show you the effect. So 50% and let's play.
I feel so close to you right now, it's like a force field.
It sounds like there's two persons singing, but under normal circumstances again, we'll leave the mix at 100. So basically for this advanced thing, unless you're doing some very advanced up adjustments, don't have to touch it, okay? And one last thing, if you need to make your overall audio sounds very good in your song, I actually did a how to mix and master your vocal video. It incorporates like 5 FX and there's like 6 to 7 steps to it. So I'll link it right here and that's it. Thank you so much to 1,150 of you guys subscribing to this channel. I started this YouTube journey like 6 years ago. Currently, I'm trying to enter this YouTube partner program, which requires me to have 4,000 watch hours. I'm still 1,000 watch hours short. So in order for me to achieve this goal, I would like to make more videos for you guys regarding music or FL Studios. So if you have any questions at all, leave it down in the comment section below. Because you know, when I do the video according to the questions that you guys give me, you guys watch the video. When you guys watch the video, it increases my watch hour, which makes me enter the YouTube partner program, which makes me achieve my goal. Until the next video, guys, I'll see you then.